Good morning. In this video, we are going to discuss another defuzzification method, that is weighted average method. So what happens in weighted average method, if we discuss it one by one, basically this method is alternatively called Sugiano defuzzification method. Why we are calling it weighted average method? Because in this, each membership function is weighted by its maximum membership value. If we ask about the mathematical representation of this method, we can represent it like in this particular formula, in which this mu x is basically the membership value, or we can say the highest value of membership in that specific part, and x is the value of the element. We will simply calculate the summation of all the elements membership value multiplied by its original value, and then we will divide the sum of all the membership value of that specific element. And in that way, we will calculate the weighted average of that specific fuzzy set. Let's see, suppose we have this specific graph as a fuzzy set. In this case, we are dividing this into different specific parts. There are four parts basically. We can say five specific parts in which we are dividing this specific graph. In this case, for the very first part, 60 is the value of x and membership of that one is 0.6. So we will multiply 60 with 0.6. For second part, 70 is the value of that specific element, that is the value of x, and its membership value, that is mu x, will be 0.4 here. Right? For this one, 80 is the value of x and mu x is 0.2 in this case. Here, 90 is the value of x and membership value is 0.2 again, and in this case 100 is basically the value of x and its mu x will be 0. So what we are going to do, we are simply going to multiply 60 with 0.6, 70 with 0.4, 80 with 0.2, 90 with 0.2 and 100 with 0, and we are getting their sum, and then we are dividing them with the sum of all these elements. Let's see it with an example over here. So in this case, as we were discussing that we have divided into different parts, and as per the formula, if we will say that this is our graph and we want to find out the weighted average for this one, how we are going to calculate? The value of x is 60 in this case, as you are seeing over here, its membership value is 0.6. okay, so 0.6 will be multiplied with 60. In second part, 70 will be multiplied with the membership value, that is 0.4. in next, we will multiply 80 with 0.2, the value of this with membership value, then 90 with 0.2, and then with 100 with 0. We will get a sum of all these values, and this will be divided with the value of all the sum of the membership values, that is 0.6, 0.4, then 0.2, then 0.2, and then 0. We'll get a sum of these things, and then we will divide these. The value of this specific part will be 98, and the sum of this specific part will be 1.4, and when we will divide 98 with 1.4, we will get 70. So in this case, if we are saying that this specific graph representing different marks or different category of a student, say initially we are saying up to 60 it is good, then up to 70 it is fair, then excellent, then very good, and so on. So we are categorizing the students in different categories over here, and we can say that in this case, the average method, the weighted average method, is representing a fair student value, because 70 is, say, for fair student. In this case, we are getting a crisp value, and that is representing the specific crisp value of that fuzzy set. So guys, this is enough for this video. In next video, we are again going to discuss some other important concepts of fuzzy logic. Till then, please like and subscribe. Thank you very much.